Now we are going to learn about business regulation in the US. And we learn how regulation helpful or harmful to business. On the helpful part, it will help to protect business consumer investor from unfair practice and fraud. It promotes US economic growth and stability. It provides transparency of information. It encourages deserved behavior through consequences for not complying. How can regulation harmful to business? It's cost of complying with regulation exists benefit. Regulation doesn't address problem or poorly designed. Regulation is excessive for the problem. Regulatory burden can be challenging for small businesses. Regulation can create a competitive disadvantage for US-based businesses. And now we move on to learn more about Security Act in 1933. This act is a trust in security law. It's reported for investor on security being offered for public sale. It prohibit deceased misrepresentation and other fraud in sale of security. Any security sold in the US must be registered. That's all about the Security Act that was issued in 1933. And now we move on to the Security Exchange Act of 1934. It's create the Security and Exchange Commission, or they call it the SEC. The SEC has broad authority over all aspects of security industry, empower SEC to require periodic reporting. Company with more than $10 million in assets with security held by more than 500 owners must file report. Proceed solicitation. Material used to solicit shareholder vote in annual or special board meeting. Tender offer. It need to disclose of important information on anyone seeking to acquire more than 5% of stock. Insider trading. This prohibit fraud in the offer, purchase or sale of security and trading on non-public information. Registration of exchange, broker dealer, transfer agent, clearing agency. This is part of the sell regulatory organization, such as the NASDAQ. And now I move on to the Bank Secrecy Act of 1970. This act fights money laundering in the US. Many business activity conducted using cash to avoid record, which are tax evasion and illegal activity. This act require bank to maintain record on cash transaction and customer relationship. It's also established reporting of cash transfer for the amount of $10,000 and over to financial claim, I mean financial crime enforcement network. Any business must have an anti-money laundering compliant program, and these are required for Bank Secrecy Act. And we move on to the Foreign Corrupt Practice Act of 1977. This act administered by US Department of Justice. And the anti-bribery